On this episode of Sportsman's News Television, we're going to go to Sonora, Mexico with WRO Mexico. JJ of Wapiti Ridge, he is just absolutely a phenomenal outfitter. We've done stuff with him for almost 10 years. His operation started in Wyoming, still got that, super successful. But recently, in the last few years, he started going down to Sonora, Mexico for big, giant mule deer. I love big mule deer. I've been to Sonora numerous times, and every time I go down there, it's we're looking for something that's 200 plus inches, absolutely giant. And we've seen him when we've been down there. I've been down there 4 times. I've yet to pull the trigger on one of those whopper bucks, but when you see those deer, it's just absolutely all you can imagine to know that you can possibly get your tag on one of them. And if you shoot 170, 180, 190 inch deer, you're never gonna kill that 220, 230, 240, possibly 250 class buck like we saw the year before. But you know, last year our pro member sweepstakes winner down there did super, super well. And this year, Greg Abbott won that hunt from us, and he is down there with James Danzy behind the camera. He's going down there. His goal is totally to find an absolute giant buck. He's killed some good deer, so he wants to get an opportunity to kill an absolute giant. Sonora, Mexico is right where you go to do it.
You know, it's funny, when Mike called, there's a bit of disbelief. You know, I'm one of those guys that was able to say, you know, I've never won anything before in my life, so, you know, a drawing or a sweepstakes or such. So anyway, disbelief, and then quite excited. It's been a hunt I've always wanted to go on, so it's, in a way, a dream come true.
You know, hunting in Sonora, there's several different techniques that are utilized when you're down there. One of them is the high rack, and you're usually doing that once you leave camp, getting out to the area, but it's just a slow, continual climb about 1,000 foot of elevation up to the base of the mountains, and to really see down into all of this, you know, cactus and yucca and everything that's there, that's the desert floor here. The way to do it is to climb way up on the top of the mountains and bust out your optics. I'm talking about 15 power binoculars and 60 power spotting scopes, where you're going to get up there, you can see down into the desert floor, and you can see those bucks running, those does running around. And then once you can find them, you can either get in closer to where you can make a shot, or at least you know where you're going to go run the high rack operation to try and get a little bit closer. But the way to do it is by glassing. It's, you know, no different than hunting some other great place where you're hunting sheep or anything. You've got to have great optics, you've got to get really good at it. And these guys that work for JJ down there, they are absolutely the best I've ever seen at being able to find deer in some of this yucca and cholla. And you know what? You find a big 220 plus inch mule deer, you're gonna be happy you learned to use great optics.
Hunting here in Mexico is definitely different than most anything I've done before. And I think even this particular location is a bit different than a lot of the way a lot of hunting is done here in Sonora. Instead of being on a ranch with you know feeders and water, you're really hunting the deer in their natural state. It's quite challenging. You do a lot of glassing. The animals don't necessarily appear just right under your feet. You may be glassing animals 1,000 yards away and have to figure out a way to get to them or get them to you. So it's unique. The most amazing thing though are the guides. They have eyes that defy belief. They see things and it takes you 5 minutes to see what they see. And if you happen to see something before they do, which is really rare, you point in a general direction and they, oh yeah, I got it, immediately. So they're superhuman, really. The food is fantastic. The people that take care of the food in the kitchen are shoving food in front of your face anytime they're within arm's reach, really. And it sounds like a sales pitch, and maybe it is, but the reality is it's been a fantastic experience all the way around.
They say size doesn't matter, but I disagree. Size matters. Was that 12 inches?
Depends on what tape.
That was part of the deal, though, huh?
Got some fish tacos.
You know, in Sonora, Mexico, not only known for big giant mule deer, it's also known for desert bighorn sheep. And when we were down there in 2015 on a deer hunt, we decided that, you know, it might be something our pro membership sweepstakes would be interested in, and getting an opportunity to sheep hunt. Very few desert bighorn sheep get shot each and every year, and we knew that if we were to advance and buy a tag for this in the future, it would be great. There's a lot of sheep down here. It's hard hunting. You're using the same techniques that you're basically using the deer, but you're not checking out the desert floor. You're checking out the mountains above you. And JJ and his team are not only good at finding big mule deer, they're really good at finding sheep. So some lucky winner in August 10th of 2016 is going to get an opportunity to get drawn out of the drum for the pro membership sweepstakes, and they're going to be headed with us in January or February of 2017 to go in and try and get an opportunity at a big desert bighorn sheep.
Thank you.
You know, you look at all of the deer that these guys are seeing sitting up on top of the mountains and seeing these beautiful horizons each and every day, and they're seeing huge deer. I mean, whether they're big giant typicals that are, you know, 180 plus, or some non-typicals that are 2x4s or 3x2s or whatever, these are just some really big deer that just about in any other circumstances, your average guy is going to want to go ahead and take a shot. And if you win this hunt or book this hunt with JJ, that's your prerogative. But Greg winning this hunt and knowing what was down there, being able to see that 220-inch deer that was killed earlier in the season, as well as the big 201 buck that Alan Denise had killed the year before, and some of the other big 200-inch deer. You know what? He's willing to hold out and pass and let bucks like this walk for that opportunity to kill that one once-in-a-lifetime buck that's 220, 230, 240. And, you know, you got to praise the guy that's willing to walk away from that, willing to go home with tag soup, just knowing that he played the game with some really, really big mule deer.
He's a nice 4x4 with a kicker. He's still a little young yet, but not a goose egg at all.
Well, when it's all said and done, you know, it's a week down here in the desert chasing big giant mule deer. And, you know, my hat's off to Greg for holding out. And he never did see the buck within range that he wanted to put his tag on. The last light of the last night, he saw a great buck that was the buck that he wanted to kill. And it's definitely enough that Greg's going to come back again next year. And one lucky winner is going to get an opportunity to go down there and hunt with him again and maybe kill that buck. So on July 10th of 2016, we're going to be giving away another Sportsman's News Pro Member Sweepstakes winner to go down with WRO Mexico and chase big trophy mule deer. So if you're not a member, make sure you sign up and become a member by July 1st so you have an opportunity going down here to Mexico and chase some of these big, giant desert mule deer. Hey, thanks for joining us on this episode of Sportsman's News Television. Tune in next month. We'll have another great show for you.
Sportsman's News Television is brought to you by Vortex Optics, the force of optics. Sitka, turning clothing into gear. CVA, it's just a better gun. Bushnell Trophy Cams, bulletproof reliability for life. Double Tap Ammunition, handcrafted, American-made precision ammunition. And by Jumping Jack, from trailer to tent in 5 minutes.